Hi girls, welcome back to my channel, Brown Skin Beautiful. This is your girl Ebony, and today I am back to talk about this hair. This is not all of my hair. I created a wig using hair from Finger Comber. Finger Comber is a brand that you can find on Instagram, and you can also find them on their website, fingercomber.com. I was actually sent this hair for review. I was sent the Kinky Wefted. As you can see, the hair is pretty tightly coiled in comparison to how it is on a wig. I actually created a wig about a month ago, so I've been wearing the hair for about a month. I did not film the video on how I created the wig because this was the first time that I've ever created a wig. Honestly, this is the first time I've ever worn a wig. So I created the wig off camera, but what I do want to show you today is how I actually install it, put the wig on, what I do with my hair underneath, and then some of the information about the hair in general. I actually really like the hair. If you're interested in seeing how I have styled this hair, some facts about the hair and all that good stuff, please keep watching. Alright, so let's get into it. So we're going to go from this puff to what you saw in the beginning. Okay, so how I prep my hair for this hair is I have it typically in a washing, not in a washing, I'm sorry, in a twist out. I posted a few photos on my Instagram, and I think I posted like some of the products I use. Like I use the Eden Body Works for the hair, and obviously for twisting my hair. But this is actually an old wash and go. Using my Organics honey ginger gel. So I mean, this will work because it does match my texture pretty close, as you've already seen. So I'm just going to show you what I do. I typically leave hair out around the perimeter of my head. And truly, it is just like one big French braid. Alright, so just so you can see, it is not anything fancy, I promise. I will turn and let you guys see what it looks like in the back. And as you can see, it's truly just one big braid down the back. It's nothing fancy. I just need to be flat to my head so that once I put the hair on top of it, it's not like coming out or it's not bulky, because I don't want it to be bulky in here. And with this one braid down, it's not going to be bulky because it is natural hair and it's big, so it'll be fine. All right, now obviously this is my hair. I probably should have done a better job of like twisting this up before the video, but you know what, we're gonna be fine. Okay, so we're going to take the hair. This is the hair. As you can see, if my hair was twisted, it'll probably mess the texture a little bit better. This is coming from a wash and go, but it will blend, I promise. This is the wig that I created. I used one bundle of hair. The hair originally, when you get it, it comes like this. This is what the bundle looks like. It does not look anything like this. And it is very, very, very deceiving. Honestly, when I first got this hair, I was like, what y'all want me to do with this? Because if you look at my hair is not long, especially in its curly state, but it certainly looks longer than this. But this hair is very, very deceiving out of the box. Okay, I had to put my glasses on because I can't read this without my glasses. We just gonna keep this all the way 100. So as far as the hair, I did reach out to the brand to find out some facts on the hair. So the hair is washable, which is true. I can validate that because I did wash this hair once I had it on the wig. Well, I guess you could say I did like a co-wash of the hair. I didn't douse it. I definitely did not submerge the hair, but I did wash it, do kind of like a comb through type of ordeal with the Eden Body Works co-wash. So that is true, it is washable. The hair only comes in one length, and it is layered 9 to 11 inches in length. The hair also can be styled and used with any products, which is also true because I've used it with a few products. I've used it with my Eden Body Works, of course, because that is like my staple for any type of twist out hairstyle. So I twisted this hair with that. I think I also used the Citrus Fusion line of Eden Body Works with this one. And I think I used the Shea Moisture Sacha Inchi. But this is a great alternative if you want to switch it up, do something new, not have to do your hair like for real, for real. It still requires some work, obviously, because I do need to twist my hair to make it blend with this. So this is the hair. It is slightly longer than my hair after I twisted it, but not a lot. So that's kind of what I like about this wig, is that it's not like I didn't go from my wash and go, which comes to here, to all of a sudden I got hair down my butt. Like, it was a transition with this hair, and honestly nobody knew that I was wearing a wig. Like, I had to for real show folks, like, so show tracks, like, legit. It doesn't look like I'm wearing a wig when I'm wearing this. It's like my hair length, it just looks fuller, which is really what I'm looking for. I like the va va boom full hair. So if that's what you're looking for, this is definitely a good alternative. I did not film how I made the wig because, again, it was my first time, and I was not about to send y'all off trying to do a video on how to make a wig and then it didn't turn out right. Like, I'm not about that life. I, you know, stick to what I know. But I think I did okay with this. So with my next wig, I might show you guys how I make it. Maybe it can, you know, if you don't know how to, I can just give you at least my steps to creating a wig. So without further ado, we are going to put this girl on. So what I do to put it on is I place it literally right behind my hair that I've had out, that I take out, and I use bobby pins. Now, I absolutely could use clips, or, you know, create clips on this wig. I just haven't. I'm okay with using bobby pins. And what I'll do is I will take a bobby pin on each side to secure it on each side. And then I will put one down the middle, or, you know, off center, but something to kind of hold it in the middle. And then on this wig, there are straps. Sometimes I'll use a strap, sometimes I won't. We'll see how I'm feeling today. If I can find them. If I can't find them, I'm not using them. Okay, I don't have time to search for them. So what I will do is take my hair, that piece that's braided down the center, tuck it under, and take two more bobby pins. You truly only need 5 bobby pins. You can use more, but honestly, I'm not a huge fan of bobby pins because I feel like they make my head hurt. So the least, the better. And I take it and I just literally attach it underneath on each side. And that's it. Okay, so now the wig is on, and anything that I have in the top, I just move back, so obviously, so you can't see the tracks. But this is what it looks like when it's on. Obviously, I probably could have did a better job of twisting my hair, but, you know, that didn't happen. I have, like, sweated my hair out just today. Literally, I swear my curls were popping, like, a couple hours ago. But it is so hot right here, and it is extremely hot with the light, the ring light. It's, like, I feel like 100 degrees. Okay. But this is it. This is the hair. I personally love the hair. I think it is an awesome match for my hair. It just makes it fuller. I mean, that's truly it, and that's the purpose of me getting the wig. Not necessarily to give me, like, these luscious locks down my back. Not that I'm saying there's anything wrong with that or I would not wear that, but for everyday practical purpose, this is good. Like, just twist up the front, and even then I can switch up how I want to wear it in the front. And so I'll show you two styles that I can do with this wig. So keep watching. Okay, so the first style can be obviously a center part. I'm typically not a center part type of girl. I'm to the side, and it's usually here. So then let's do that part. But actually, I kind of have been liking center parts with this wig. Ordinarily, no, I'm not a center part girl. With this wig, I kind of like it. And just kind of fluff it out. Then I know there, I think I had a picture on Instagram where I pinned one side back. Forward a bit, you know, fluff it to your liking. And obviously, no, that's two. So there's a center part. You can pull it back, take that out. All right, girls, and that is it. This is the finger comber unit that I created with the Kinky Wefted Hair, and these are the results. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions, please, please, please leave them down below. If you are not already subscribed, please subscribe to my channel for more videos on natural hair, protective styling, and more stuff like this. See you in the next one. Bye.